In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. Well, Allah Almighty is stated in Quran.
وبينات من الهدى والفرقان.
Allah Almighty, in this very holy verse, has attributed three features to Quran. The one, Hudan Linnas. The second one, Bayyinatin Min Al-Huda, and the third one, Furqan. There have been stated plenty of interpretations, particularly the one stated by the Ahlul Bayt. They have all said the same thing. Huda linnas is all about Islamic beliefs, Islamic moralities, Islamic rulings. Quran, Allah revealed Quran, one for this reason, and that is Huda linnas. It is not merely revealed for believers. It has been revealed for everyone. It is a guidance for all humanity, not merely Muslims or believers. The day in which Quran was revealed, how many believers did exist? Just two. One, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and the other one, Imam Ali, alayhi salam. Peace be upon them both. Abi Talib, Abdul Muttalib. They were also had their own belief and faith, and we have no doubt about it. But people were not believers. Quran. Has also addressed all humanity, not only believers. So Quran is for all human beings. It addresses its speech to all human beings, not only people in Iran, people from in Iraq, or merely Muslims. When we are talking about Quran, whom we are addressing our speech to? What's the population of the world? More than, it is said, more than 7 billion people. They are all our addressee. That's one side of the issue tonight. And the other, there is the phrase وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى. Late Ayatollah Tusi stated and talked about this issue. He said it's all about prophets' news. And there, it's nothing but lessons for all humanity. The stories of Ahlul Bayt, prophets, are much more than the hadith and verses regarding Islamic rules, because they are considered as life, lessons about life, for they have a strong effect on people. They're more influential. When you read the stories in Quran, we, as experts, are affected. The impact is much more than the verses regarding Islamic rules or the stories of pious jurists. They sometimes encourage us more than the blessings made by the experts. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَىٰ as is stated, is regarded and related to the stories of Ahlul Bayt and Prophets, and they're considered all lessons of life. And the third one is Furqan. Furqan here is the cutting line between right and wrong, what is legitimate or illegitimate. It has been stated in traditions, prophets came and invited people to monotheism, unity, hereafter imamat, and before Ahlul Bayt and prophets, people were all same and they were all infidels. They were all hypocrites. These were the prophets who came and showed what is right and what is wrong.
Like an
genuine money or the fake one. The one who is making the fake money does some delicate stuff so that no one can understand what is fake and what is genuine. But the one who is an expert knows the difference, knows how to recognize what is fake or what is genuine. How can we distinguish the accurate and the correct Islam and the incorrect Islam? Do we have an incorrect Islam? Of course we do. The one which was followed by Bani Umayyah or Bani Abbas. Quran would differentiate among those. And this is about the third one.
این الفرقانم به خصوص خدای تبارک و تعالی با ال ذکر کرده.
Quran added a prefix to the word Furqan and it stated al-Furqan.
یه دونه از اینا یک حبر یهودی و مسلمان شیعه کرده.
And all these delicate issues encourage people to convert to Islam. Many of them were infidel experts, hypocrites. They were all delicate points made by Quran regarding its accuracy and fluency. I would like to skip this point. Well, you are all experts in the field. You're all teachers. seminary students, you all are aware of this. Huda has been stated without prefix.
بينات
من الهدى.
البينات.
The saying. I'm talking about this very verse.
بعد فرموده وفرقانا.
He didn't say وفرقانا. Of course, in somewhere other verses, it is stated وفرقانا.
حق وباطل از هم تمیز میده.
What's the prefix? The prefix al is doing here.
هدى للناس بألف لام.
هدى للناس بينات من الهدى without prefix.
والفرقان.
But والفرقان, this prefix has been added. Well, as Arabic literature states, as you might and you have opportunity to refer to,
in agar al ahd nabashe qablish ye chizi nabashe ki in al ishare be ahd bashe age in nabashe in al zuhur dar hasr dare. Quran hidayat ast.
Quran is a guidance.
بینات من الهداس اما تنها فارق بین حق.
And this is the only thing that can differentiate between what is wrong and what is right.
معاویه ها هم
قرآن. People like Muawiyah used to have Quran. People like Yazid used to have Quran as well. People like Mutawakkil. And this Quran is the only thing that can distinguish and differentiate between what is wrong and what is right.
Al-Quran hudan lin-nas hidayate bayyinatin min al-hudas.
And as I stated, Quran is considered to be as the only matter and also the only thing that can differentiate between what is right and what is wrong. This is a very general issue, and it has been stated in many books. You can refer to them. Some of you might already know about it. What's the difference between what is wrong and what is right? It has been stated in many traditions. Ramadan is the spring of Quran. What's the difference between the spring and the other seasons, like summer, winter? Well, as you see, it's a time when flower, the blossoms will open. And Ramadan is the spring of Quran. What does it mean? Undoubtedly, it means we have to read Quran. We have to memorize Quran. We also have to comprehend and understand the real concepts of Quran. And there is no doubt about these issues. But they're not obligatory and mandatory issues. They're all religiously recommendatory issues. We are all recommended to finish Quran from the beginning 40 times in Ramadan. Some people read Quran, but they do not ponder about their real concept. Quran is like a doctor's prescription. You have to read it. But this is only the beginning step. You have to understand this, and you have to act upon it. If you make a mistake, a subtle mistake, you might suffer dire consequences. But what is generally Essential here is acting upon what Quran has ordered us to do. It's a prescription for this world and the hereafter. It's a prescription for all good deeds. It's a key to all prosperity. It's a key for getting away and standing away from all sinister deeds. But we have to act upon it. It's better to open up a religious issue here. Many might be ignorant of this. What's the meaning of acting upon Quran? For example, the one who is married, as an example, couples have some rights. Quran talked about this issue. The husband must know, the wife also must know what are their rights regarding each other. And if they know what are their rights and they do not fulfill their rights, it's a pity. If a husband understands what are his wife's rights are, he has to act upon it, he has to fulfill his rights. There has been a stated in a tradition, what I'm saying now is just a simple, a subtle warning to experts. But this might be a new issue for many people. Those who read Quran and do not act upon him. This tradition has been stated by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. The taraqi is the plural form of tarqaba. When we read, we open up our mouth. We use our vocal cords.
یا زبان یا فضای فم یا زبانی که به اطراف اسنان میخوره.
We use our mouth muscles to utter the Quranic words.
فضای فم حلقوم که بعض حروف از اونها در میاد. ترقوه کجاست؟
ترقوه Where is it located?
دو طرف حلقوم.
These are two bones located in the sides of the throat. This is a metaphor.
نفر بودن لا تجاوزو حلقومهم نفر بودن تراقی هم
This is a metaphor.
قرآن کنایات درش
قرآن is filled with metaphors.
معنی حقیقی خیلی بیشتره انواع کنایات
Much more than real meanings.
مجاز کنایات این جزء بلاغت یعنی از این
It means from these two bones, I mean taqwa, in which, among which, throat is located.
برای اون حروف قرآن کریم که از زبان و اطراف اسنان
And this by this throat we are just uttering Quranic words
بین ترقوس یعنی ظاهر فرمایش حضرت
What I simply assume from Prophet's statement it means those who read Quran and do not act
از این بین ترقوه عبور نمیکنه یعنی با زبونش قرآن خونده اما کأنه این زبونه نخونده
It means as if those who read Quran and they do not act upon it as if they have not read Quran at all
حالا پشت سر همین جمله در روایت
Well regarding this issue in Prophet's tradition the word ulaik has been stated
عمل نمیکنن شر خلق الله
And those who read Quran and do not act upon it are nothing but evils. Reading Quran is recommendatory. It's really good. But if you read it and do not act upon it,
نه فقط این قرآن خوندن مفید
Not only this reading
Quran
قرآن
بلکه چارچوبه شر خلق الله
It is also a sinister deed
کسی که مریض بود نسخه نداشت
Imagine a sick person a patient without a prescription He might feel pain but the one who As a prescription, and he knows what to do to cure himself and does not act upon it, he should be blamed. The holy month of Ramadan is the spring of Quran. We have to preach what has been stated in Quran. But what is really important here is we have to act upon the concepts of
Quran.
Muawiyah also used to read Quran. Imam Ali also used to read Quran. But which one was right? Who did act upon it? He came to Ali, alayhi salam, in Jamal War. They're both sides are companions of prophets. Imam Ali, middle of the war, said a statement. We have to be really careful. And vigilant regarding this delicate points, the points which could change the world as they have already did, they have already done. Imam Ali, in the middle of the war, said a statement to one of his opponents. It is stated that Imam Ali alayhi salam, peace be upon him, has nine statements which are truly precious. Alayhi salam, in the middle of the war, told someone, go, contemplate,
فلا يتفكرون أفلا يعرفون ببین حق چیه.
And contemplate what is right.
And you see
which one is legitimate and which one is illegitimate.
Quran,
regarding this verse, in which he said, Quran was revealed in Ramadan.
یکیش تنها فرقان قرآنه، غیر قرآن فرقان نیست، مگر اونایی که تابع قرآنن، مثل خود پیغمبر خدا صلی الله علیه و آله.
People like Prophet who used to follow Quran, they used to act upon Quran, their moralities were, his moralities were based on Quran.
اونا هم فرقانن، تابع قرآنن. اگر نه غیر قرآن فرقان نیست.
There is nothing like Quran which can distinguish what is right and what is wrong.
اونایش که راست از خدا اومد، نه اونایش که دستش برده شد.
Holy Bible,
کتب
the parts which are original could also differentiate. But the only and the precious thing that can differentiate between what is right and what is wrong is Quran. Ramadan is the spring of Quran. May God bless us all and give us the opportunity to get the most out of this month. We're all obliged to.
ما اونی که درکش بیشتره،
those who are able to understand more, comprehend more, and they are physically capable more, their responsibilities are also bigger, and it's quite natural.
وقت این مراجعه که ما میکنیم به اونایی که نمای عرف القرآن من خطبه به
When we refer to those who acted upon Quran, like 14 infallibles, we'll get astonished by what they have done and what they have said. Well, the religious Islamic rule I would like to talk about is, there is a married woman. She has a husband. They have to know their rights, religious rights, regarding each other. They have to learn and they have to act upon them. The husband must not do haram thing. Wife also must not do haram thing. Well, let's consider a single boy or a single girl. Do they have to learn about these issues? Why not? Of course, they're not religiously obliged to, for they are still bachelors. It's also self-explanatory. The single boy or single girl is not religiously obliged to learn about the matrimonial issues.
But
he can learn so he can teach others. Teach those who are married.
یعنی اون خانومی هم که ازدواج نکرده برش واجبه، قدری که میتونه، قدری که در تزاحمات.
A single girl also is recommended to learn matrimonial issues so she can let others know, especially those who are married. He must, and she must know what are their rights regarding each other. A teacher must let the girls and the boys know about these issues in school, universities, neighbors. For we are obliged to let each other know about Islamic issues.
اگر منفی الکفایه بود یه چند میلیون بودن بلد بودن این مسائل را و تو ماهواره ها دارن بیان میکنن و به همه رسید.
But if the whole world is aware of this issue, which is not, so there's no need to learn.
یعنی تمام مسائل شرعی واجبات و محرمات بر قضات چی واجبه چی حرومه بر خود قاضی واجب یاد بگیره بر من و شما شمای مسلمان شما
مسلمان
من
you Muslims,
زن مؤمن بقال عطار
believers
طباخ آشپز
everyone in his business
در اونم در حدی که تزاحم اهم نداره واجبه
We're all obliged to learn about these issues so we can avoid and stop people from doing bad deeds and encourage them to do good deeds. If all are aware of this issue, we're not then obliged to. But since not all people are aware of these issues, we are religiously obliged to learn about these issues and let others know about them as well. One might know, but does not act upon it.
بس اینجور نیست که خانومی که ازدواج نکرده برش
So we cannot say the single girl is not obliged to learn about this issue or the single boy as well
برش واجب نباشه مسائل زنداری رو بدونه هر دو
They're both whether single or married are obliged to learn about this issue
اون زن که شوهر داره برش واجبه واجبات شوهر براش چیه که به شوهر خودش هم بگه اگه بلد نیست بگه اگه بلده و عمل نمی کنه از باب امر به معروف بش بگه از باب نهی از معروف الفرقان
This الفرقان This phrase is really significant
خدای تبارک و تعالی یه دونه الف لام نعوذ بالله
This prefix has not been added haphazardly. We have to figure about this issue. And this can be done in Ramadan. It's a all-time, lifetime duty, but we're all recommended to do so in Ramadan. There are plenty of people, they were and there will be, generally those who are illegitimate use two techniques, one, lying and exaggeration. And these two would are influential on people and common people, actually. You can refer and prove it yourself. This story backs to 20 or 30 years ago. One of the Shia opponents and opposers who wrote many books, I saw a statement which by which I was shocked.
He
was lying too much.
He
was an expert in lying. He was talking about Imam Mahdi.
اسمشو گفتم شما مراجعه کنید حالا یادم نیست تو کدوم کتابشه یه وقتی یاد
I do not remember the source
کتابش صفحه شم گفت تو اونجا میگه امام زمان هنوز بدون
In that book he said that Imam Zaman still did not born
بزرگ شیعه اقرار به این کرده اون شیخ
And one of the Shia scholar like Sheikh Saduq confessed this issue
کتاب اون میگه احسان الهی ظهیر
And he gave the source in his book.
فلان صفحه میگوید که امام زمان به دنیا نیامدن هنوز.
I was quite shocked about this.
مرحوم شیخ صدوق خیلی چیز
We have heard plenty of things from Sheikh Saduq. But nothing like that.
یه دونه بچه شیعه این حرفو نمیزنه. یه دونه بچه‌ای که حق الیقین علامه مجلسی رو دیده.
No one can say that Sheikh Saduq has said such a statement. What Sheikh Saduq said, I refer to the source. He talked about Imam Mahdi. And he then said that there are some people who deny the existence of Imam Mahdi. Some say that Imam Mahdi has not been born yet. And he mistakenly attributed this lie to Sheikh Saduq. What is right? What is legitimate and illegitimate? The legitimate and right thing is that Imam Mahdi was born, he exists. This is right. This is Quran which can distinguish and differentiate what is right and what is wrong. We experts, religious experts, are much more responsible. And we are obliged to let the whole world know about this. To believers and non-believers, Muslims and non-Muslims, wise or unwise people. An unwise person is obliged to learn, and an expert is obliged to teach. Quran differentiates what is wrong and what is wrong.
فرقانیت قرآن را هم او باید یاد بگیره جاهل همین باید یاد بده اما خدا اول به عالم گفته بگو
But Quran ordered
the experts to teach
and he also addressed to his speech to unwise people to learn.
تو دنیا میگن الان 7000 میلیون بیش از 7000 میلیون بشر آدم هست.
It is said that there are 7 billion people are living and more than 5 billion are religious people. There might be infidels among them. Atheists as well. Quran is also for them as well.
اینا همه معاند باشن.
Not all are atheists. Not all are enemies and infidels. So Quran is for all of them. And they all can be guided. They all can be guided to the straight path.
انجام میدیم اینا واجبات عینیه است چون من فیل کفایه نیست او آدم خیلی
the one who is a sinister
قابلیت داره که خیلی خوب بشه تو تاریخ
is capable of turning to be a righteous person. You experts are all aware of this.
180 درجه پیچیده وقتی که حقو فهمیده کم کسیه که حقو بفهمه و نپیچه.
When an unwise person gets to know about the reality and truth, he would turn to be a wise man, like Bahar, Allama Majlisin Bahar al-Anbar, which has been stated in many books. I have personally seen this. Sayyid Bahr al-Ulum, when he was a jurist, traveled from Najaf to Karbala, passing through gardens and waters. There was a small town which exists now, called a place where Zulkif was buried. It is called Kefil. There was a seminary school for Jews.
As I read,
there were four seminary schools for Jews. One of them was there. In a time in which he was really busy, he passed away in 1211,
Ujaira.
He used to discuss with Jews. One of the religious experts in Shia wrote a book about his discussion with Jews.
Bahr al-Ulum
used to discuss and debate with Jews. And he confessed that they have all turned and converted to Islam.
أحبار يهودي كقرآن بفرماد ولتجدن أشد الناس عداوة للذين آمنوا اول قرآن میگه یهود بعد میگه بت پرستا و الذین اشرکوا ای سید بحر العلوم
لایت بحر العلوم when he was a jurist
تورات و تلمود اینا رو حفظ کرده حتما نه تو جوانی در کلان درسایی که میخونده در کنار درس
when he was young he used to learn all about the Bibles, Old Testament and New Testament, so we can have the ability to discuss and turn people to Islam. Do you think that Jews would not convert to Islam? Of course they would. But you have to have the ability and tact to talk about the truth. There are plenty of examples stated in history. I have read thousands of examples stated in plenty of books regarding Jews experts and other denomination experts, idol worshippers as well. There are millions of idol worshippers.
همشون حمال نیستن اینا میلیون ها استاد دانشگاه دارن با سواد
دارن. They have experts, but they're idol worshippers.
اما بودایی، اما ملحد.
They're atheists.
الفرقان که بهارش ماه مبارک رمضانه اینه. سید بحرالعلوم تو جوانی این چیزها رو حفظ نکرده بود، واجب بود حفظ کنه.
بحرالعلوم was not obliged to learn about these issues.
این هم یکی از مقدمات وجود.
But he did.
این مقدمش اثرش یکیش اینه. حالا اونای دیگرش من یادم نیست، کل تاریخ سید بحرالعلوم یادم نیست. یکیش اینه که شون سبب شده که احبار یهود عدهی
had the chance and succeeded in converting Jews to Islam.
فقیه بزرگوار میگه اینا شیعه شدن. همون وقت لحظه شیعه نشدن، بعد که سید رفتن اینا شیعه شدن.
They all turned to Shiism.
خب اینا میموندن بر یهودیت، گناهش کردن کی بود؟
And if they remained, if they have remained in Judaism, who would have been responsible? Some might not be able. They're not capable of doing so. So there's no problem with that. But since we are able, we have to. We have to let the whole world know about these issues. Not only and merely Middle East.
مخاطب من و شما هر بشری که میشه حرف بهش برسه. حالا
our addressee, the whole world, those who can listen.
اگه نپذیرفت اتمام حجت شده. قرآن فارقه فرقانه.
Quran can differentiate between what is wrong and what is right.
لئلا یکون این تو آیات قرآن. وظیفه من و شما و هر مسلمان.
We're all religiously obliged.
غیر مسلمان مؤمن و غیر مؤمنه که قرآن قبول داره.
To read Quran and act upon it and let the whole world know. Let the whole world know about us.
حجة. سید بحر العلوم نمی رفتن با این احبار یهود بحث کنن و اینا میموندن یهودی میمردن.
If Bahra'l-Ulum hasn't talked about them, they would have remained Jews. And they could have brought up excuses in the hereafter.
Why did they not come?
For they were all deprived of information regarding Islam and Shiism.
گفت فخر رازی به این ملایی چطور اینجور اهل باطل شد؟ گفت فخر رازی ملا که اهل باطل نشد. فخر
Jews
رازی اهل باطل
converted.
بود با تمرکز بر باطل بودن اومد بالا، اومد بالا شد فخر رازی. احبار یهود شده حبر یهود. اما واقعا اینایی که مسلمان شده معلومه بهشون
We have to preach.
نرسیده در حدی که باور کنه. وقت باید انسان بگه در حدی که باور کنه.
One of the significant issue in today's role. We are all responsible regarding distinguishing and differentiating what is right and what is wrong.
که وظیفه همه است، ماها وظیفمون بیشتره از باب والفرقان، جدا کردن حق و باطل از هم دیگه. که تو راه هدایت بشر وارد بشه، مقدمات وجودش تهیه بشه. حالا اونی که ممکنه اون احبار یهودی که سید بحرالعلوم باشون صحبت کردن همشون مسلمان شیعه نشدن، اما اونی که نشد حجتی بر خدا نداره. لئلا یکون
Some might not be aware of these issues and they can justify They have not been informed about what is right and what is wrong, like Jews or Christians.
اگه واقعا یک حبر یهودی
If they are not informed, we cannot blame them.
یک عالم مشرک قدری بهش نرسید که باور کنه این درسته.
Islamic rules are for all people. But those who do not believe.
احکام اسلام برای همه است، اما اونی که
they're not obliged. But if they understand about rules and they do not act, they must be blamed and they must be punished in hereafter. One of the significant issues today, particularly in non-Islamic countries, there is too much liberty and freedom. They might not be aware of Islam and Islamic issues. They might be skeptical about Islam. Those cruel things that oppressors are doing, like ISIS, which are doing, following blasphemies, which are beheading innocent kids, they're just falsely and negatively advertising about Islam. Who is responsible to show the real Islam? Who is responsible to let the whole world know that they're not Muslims and they're not following the real meaning of Islam? We are all obliged to. This is a big responsibility.
تمکنمون از این جهت بیشتر بیشتر هست. دنبالش میتونیم بریم، میتونیم یاد بگیریم.
There have been stated plenty of stories in history.
که تو تاریخ چند سطر نوشته شده. و همه تواریخ عامه و خاصه داره.
In all rulings and regulations.
نقل کردن،
What is done to a spy, to a traitor, the one who has played with the domestic security? Nothing but death penalty. Well, I remember, and you can ask, there is a place, Ummatubul,
که از عراق میان از بغداد یا بپرسید امبول یه منطقه خارج بغداد.
There is a mosque now near that place. Dul Karim Qasim came and made a revolution.
دست چپمون بود قبل بغداد امبول.
After a year or two.
یعنی بعد یه مسجد درست کرد. عبدالکریم قاسم اومد انقلاب
کرد. He claimed that there were some traitors.
بعد یکی دو سه سال
He arrested some people in that particular religion, which was nothing but a desert. He hanged them, executed them. Then he was defeated, and they made a bill. They made a mosque there. But they were all executed because of treason. A non-Muslim would mistakenly come up with some false conclusion regarding Islam.
وقتی هم که رد میشه اونی که غیر مسلمانه میاد میگه اینجا ام الطبول چیه میگن اینجا اعدام کرده عبدالکریم قاسم
There might be some two or three countries which execution does not exist
دنیا امروز هم متعارفه بله یه
Prophet Muhammad peace be upon him
درجه اعدام نیست که اونم بی منطقی از یه جهت حالا سر جای خودش پیغمبر خدا صلی الله علیه و آله قصه
The story of Hatib ibn Abi Baltah. It's a quite common story.
قصه حاطب ابن ابي بلتعه یه دونه و دو تا و ده
hundreds of stories like that.
صد تانی تو تاریخ پیغمبر خدا.
حالا این حاطب ابن ابي بلتعه was a traitor.
صد تانه باشه اما
he used to pretend to be a Muslim. He used to pray behind prophet.
حاطب ابن ابي بلتعه
used to fast in Ramadan. He used to listen and sit in front of Prophet's pulpit as a lady who was a singer from among hypocrites of Mecca, she was asked to go and ask Hatib ibn Abi Baltah to write some reports about Prophet's war strategies. And this is not about spying. The lady came. Prophet saw her. Prophet knew that she was a singer. Prophet knew that she had some relationship with young people of hypocrites. Prophet, what brought you? Prophet said, what brought you here? She said, I came here to travel. She said, I have no money. I'm here to ask for money. Prophet smiled.
پولم کم شده اومدم اینجا برکن یه معنی تحصیل کنم ببینید بحار غیر بحار
couldn't the young people supply for you
فرمودن جوانای مکه کافیت نبودن
Hatib ibn Abi Baltah wrote letter to hypocrites of Mecca and revealed the secrets of Prophet's war strategies. This lady concealed this letter in her hair. She then moved toward Mecca. Prophet knew all about this. But he didn't want to do any drastic action so that people would believe what is right and what is wrong. Prophet told two of his companions to go and search for such a letter from that lady. They came and asked her for the letter. She denied and she rejected. They came down, they searched her, they searched the camel, but they didn't find anything.
گفتن بیا پایین از چطور اومد پایین گشتن دو نفر دیگه با حضرت امیر علیه السلام بودن گشتن هر چی گشتن نامه پیدا نکردن
علی علیه السلام said that prophet does not lie there must be a letter
پیدا نکردن گفت نیست
امیرالمومنین پیغمبر خدا just for a mere threat said give me a letter or I will behead you
حضرت امیر فرمودن میدی نامه رو یا گردنت همینجا بزنم.
She was scared and she gave away the letter.
اونم دید قصه جدیه دست کرد از لای موهای بافتش.
Would they, did they execute or hang the lady?
شما به دنیای امروز خطاب
Let the whole world know about this. Did they put her in prison? Did they torture her? No. Let the whole world know about this story.
میرن شکنجش بکنن یا نه.
The one who is satellite, the one who is wealthy, must advertise this story to whole world. The one who is a lecturer must let the whole world know about this, must inform the world about this. Ali alayhi salam took the letter and gave it to Prophet.
Wal Furqan, e Furqane, tu mah Ramazan bayad bayan beshe dune dune. Khob.
Prophet told Hatib ibn Abi Balta that this is your letter, and he confessed to reality. He asked, why did you write such a letter? Consider the whole history, except the history regarding prophets. Would you find such an example, such a divine procedure implemented by Prophet Muhammad? This story might change the world if it's told in a right way. Prophet told him, why did you write such a letter? He said, I was afraid. I thought that hypocrites might be predominating so that I would get close to them. So that they would not torture me or tease me. But Prophet did not put him in prison, did not torture him, nor did he execute him. These are the bright points of Islam. We have to let the whole world know about this. Or the story regarding Ali alayhi salam. Or the about the Safin and the companions of Muawiyah. Ali alayhi salam said to his companions, attack, take water, take Furat River. They attacked and they took the river. Some of the companions came and said, you should not let the companions of Muawiyah to let them use water. Ali alayhi salam knew all about this. Muawiyah and Amras were all scared. Muawiyah said, I knew Ali. We should not let the whole world know and inform the world about this issue. Amir al-Mu'minin could have deprived them from water. But this is not a good deed, this is a real bad deed. Ali alayhi salam had the right to deprive them from water, but he did not. When someone invades, you can retaliate, but
که تعدی کرد شما هم حق دارید نه واجبه حق دارید
you have the right but it means you are obliged to
حق دارید رخصت رخصت دلیل لا رخصت لا اقتضا لا اقتضا با اقتضا تزاحم هیچ وقت پیدا میکنه هیچ وقت مباح
Islamic leaders should act in a way regarding enemies and friends.
اسلام یه جوری باشه عمل کرده رئیس مسلمین یک جوری باشه با دوست و دشمن که لیهلک من هلک عن بینه و یحیی من حی عن بینه. این دلیل اقتضاییه. دلیل اقتضا.
For example, if you get to be an Islamic ruler and such a thing
happened,
you must not retaliate.
فمن اعتدى عليكم فاعتدوا عليه بمثل ما.
For this could be an obstacle for some people's guidance, people of Safin, who saw what Ali alayhi salam treated them.
همین اهل صفین که دیدن این برخورد با امیر المؤمنین اینجور که نقل میکنن یه عدهشون برگشتن.
امیر المؤمنین could have taken the opportunity, could have deprived them from water.
درست بود که فرصت را از اینا بگیرن رد اعتدای به مثل بکنن.
If you let the world know about this story, and if you tell the story in a correct way, you can lead many people to the right path.
درست مطرح بشه.
You can convert, let the Jews convert to Islam.
خیلی با همین هدایت کنید. همون احبار یهود را میتونید شیعه کنید با همین یه دونه قصه.
You might have read about this. In the day of Ashura, Shem, may God curse upon him, shouted and swore at Prophet, at Imam Hussein.
لعنتالله عليه اومد داد زد دشنام به امام حسین داد. حالا صف بستن گفتنم میخواییم امام حسین رو بکشیم.
She said, he said some nasty word to Imam Hussein. One of Imam Hussein's
companions
came and said, I can kill him right now. Shem was an infidel. He used to swear at Imam Hussein. He could have martyred than he did. But Imam Hussein said, and this is something by which we can change the whole world. They came to kill and martyr Imam Hussein, but Imam Hussein said, I would not start the war. Well, millions of people could have been guided by us, since we're now able to lead them. God would blame us that why we have not told them. Of course, yes, this might be a tough task for informing people. Prophets also had plenty of problems preaching Islam. Go and search the traditions regarding Prophet. But what they were killed because of these difficulties. Bani Umayyad and Bani Abbas thought that it would be prophets and Ahlul Bayts were nothing but a barrier in front of their power. The story of Khabbab. Khabbab used to be a great companion of Prophet.
خباب یکی از اصحاب خوب پیغمبر خدا صلی الله علیه و آله. این از کساییه که تو مکه مکرمه من عمده جوانهای مؤمنین و مؤمنات خانمهای جوان پسرهای جوان در تمام
Well, I recommend all Muslim girls and boys to read about these stories.
هر جای دنیا هستن سفارش میکنم بخونید بخونید وظیفه است که بخونید مگه قدی که نتونید قدرت از شرایط عامه تکلیف
This خباب
هم واجب بخونید بدونید هم واجب برسونید
was among those who believed first in Islam and Prophet and hypocrites used to torture him much.
مشرکین هم خیلی شکنجش کردن. نوشتن یکی از اون 6 نفر یا 7 نفریه.
He was among those who believed in Islam after Imam Ali alayhi salam.
که به پیغمبر اسلام ایمان آوردن بعد امیرالمؤمنین. امیرالمؤمنین که از قبل خلقت در عالم ذر مؤمن بودن.
After Imam Ali, 6 or 7 people were among those who initially believed in Islam. And Khabbab used to be loyal to Prophet and Imam Ali. He helped, assisted Imam Ali in some of his wars.
در بعضی جنگ‌های
امام علی واز این کوفه
اداره و قیادت امیرالمؤمنین جنگ کرد و
امیرالمؤمنین
صلوات الله علیه تو کوفه بودن یکی دو سال قبل از شهادت حضرت مرد
امام علی prayed for him
و امیرالمؤمنین داره
and he was among the first ones who buried who was buried in Wadi Salam
در وادی سلام دفن شد ظاهرا این قبل اون صافی و صافی صفا است که اونجا غریب به ظهر الکوفه
yes,
اول من دفن
was tortured by hypocrites
از یمن آوردن جنازش
in painful ways
این خباب نوشتن مشرکین شکنجهش میکردن چه شکنجه یکی از شکنجه هاش نوشتن اینه
they used to
اجلش نرسیده بود که
نه کم نکد
کمتر از این آدم گاهی میمیره
and put a burning log on his back
دست و پاشو میگرفتن کنده هیزم را آتش میکردن رو کمرش میگذاشت تو سرد میشه خب طبیعی این بیهوش میشده از سوزش وقت ظاهر روایات و تاریخ این خود بحارم دم دست ملاحظه کن
They have tortured him repeatedly. And there were marks on his back up to his last breath. They wanted him to confess that he was not a Muslim and deny the legitimacy of Prophet.
بگو پیغمبر رو قبول ندارم این یک کلمه رو نمیگو با اینکه جایز بود بگه قرآن اجازه داده بود
We have to
اگه من و شما به این
If something happens to us
خب جایز تقیه بکنم اونم واجب نیست
But nothing happens like today's world Well, there might be people like Saddam who used to torture people
چیزا توش نیست حالا یه صدام بود از این کارا میکرد و حالا این داعشی ها میکنن نعوذ بالله امثالش اما کمتر هست این چیزا بله یه توانی داره
There were plenty of difficulties for prophets They were under plenty of hardships and tortures And that's why Many of prophets and Ahlul Bayt were martyred, not just merely passed away. Why Fatima Zahra was martyred? Why was Imam Ali martyred? Imam Hussein, Imam Hussein as well.
Hazrat Muhsin pay chi koshte shudan? Hazrat Amir al-Mu'minin pay chi koshte shudan? Imam Hasan pay chi koshte shudan? Imam Hussein pay chi koshte shudan?
We must try not to be regretful in hereafter.
من به همه مسلمین و مسلمات جهان این را عرض میکنم که فرقان قرآن کریمه خصوصا جوانان.
We should act, we should teach so that we might not be believing in hereafter, that why we haven't taught, why we haven't let the whole world know. We haven't been patient.
چرا یه خورده تحمل نکردی؟ چرا یه خورده صبر نکردی؟ چرا یه خورده حلم نکردی؟ چرا ولمن صبر و غفر نبودی؟ چرا این آیه شریف قل ان کان آباکم و ابناکم و و و احب الیکم من الله و رسوله و جهاد.
Ramadan is the spring of Quran. It's for all people, for everywhere.
بهارش ماه مبارک. مال همه دوره سال. مال همه جا.
Here to say what time are we allowed to do taghiyah. Sheikh Ansari has written a book about this. In some cases taghiyah is haram, in some cases it is an obligatory issue.
همجور که یه جاهای تقیه واجبه یه جاهای هم حرامه کشته میشه بشه.
In some cases it is recommendatory, some
وقتی کشته شد بشه جایز.
Obligatory and in some cases it is haram.
برای یه جاهای جایزه، یه جاهای مکروهه، یه جاهای مستحبه. یه جاهای هم واجبه. بله، حال منم در مقام بیان مسئله شرعی نیستم. این کبرا رو میخوام.
Quran differentiates between what is right and what is wrong. And Quran has stated all ways to contemplate.
یاد بگیریم تو خود قرآن هی فرموده تدبرو لیتدبرو فتدبرو لیتفکرو.
I hope
قرآن میفرماد هدن
this holy month will be blessful for all people, Muslims and non-Muslims. May God hasten the advent of Imam Mahdi. May God hasten Imam Mahdi's advent. And I hope that he gives us the opportunity to know about our duties and acting upon them. Even if it's filled with hardships. I pray for you all in Ramadan and pray for me as well. We are all in need of prayers. May God bless Muhammad and his descendants.
Muhammad wa alihi at-tahirin.